Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to another ATP video. In our previous videos we covered some of the gram-negative bacilli and diplococci. Now let's talk about the gram-negative coccobacilli. The one that we'll talk about today is Haemophilus influenza, and like we're used to, let's begin with its distinguishing feature. Haemophilus influenza is an aerobic gram-negative coccobacilli. It's catalase and oxidase positive, and the name Haemophilus literally means blood-loving. This is because it requires hematin, or factor 10, and NAD, or nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, also known as factor 5, and both of these are found in RBCs. And like we said, it requires both of these to grow. And since we're talking about how Haemophilus influenza grows, let's move on to the lab stuff. So you might think that Haemophilus influenza grows on blood agar because of its requirement for factor 10 and 5. However, Haemophilus influenza is incapable of blood hemolysis, so it can't grow on blood agar by its own. Instead, we use chocolate agar to grow it. And if you remember from our previous video on Neisseria species, chocolate agar is basically a blood agar that has been heated and lysed. Thus, it provides Haemophilus influenza with hematin and NAD from the lysed RBC for growth. Also, Haemophilus influenza may demonstrate satellitism in culture. But what does that mean? This means that Haemophilus influenza can grow on blood agar only in the presence of hemolytic bacteria such as Staphylococcus aureus. And by satellite, you can see here how the colonies of H. flu surround Staph aureus like a satellite. Now let's talk about the virulence factors. Haemophilus influenza uses IgA protease to infect the mucosal surfaces by breaking immunoglobulin A. In addition, some strains have polysaccharide capsule, which can be one of six types: A, B, C, D, and F. These strains, particularly type B, are more invasive than non-encapsulated strains. Okay, now let's get to the clinical relevance. Here we will focus on the diseases caused by H. influenza type B. And the first disease is epiglottitis. Haemophilus influenza type B can cause swelling of the epiglottis, which results in obstruction of the respiratory tract and esophagus, which then causes the child to develop stridor and dysphagia. Just a side note, stridor is high-pitched wheezing sound caused by disrupted airflow. And in this case, the swollen epiglottis causes the disruption in the airflow. And dysphagia is simply difficulty swallowing. Also, the child will present with drooling because the saliva is unable to pass the swollen epiglottis. On examination, the swollen epiglottis appears as cherry red, and on X-ray, it's characterized by the thumb sign. The next disease is meningitis. After the inhalation of Haemophilus influenza, it invades the bloodstream, and then it goes to the meninges. The infected child presents with fever, irritability, vomiting, and altered mental status. Next is septic arthritis. Haemophilus influenza type B is a common cause of septic arthritis in infants. It presents with fever, pain, swelling, and decreased joint mobility. It's good to know that children with absent spleen, in the cases of splenectomy, or non-functioning spleens in case of sickle cell disease, are at highest risk of getting infected with Haemophilus influenza type B, since the spleen is the most important organ in fighting encapsulated organisms. Now for the non-typable strains of Haemophilus influenza, which are also known as non-encapsulated strains, they're usually non-invasive, since they don't have the capsule. Thus, they're more associated with causing local disease, such as otitis media and sinusitis. For the treatment of infection of Haemophilus influenza type B, we use third-generation cephalosporin, such as ceftriaxone. However, in case of meningitis in children, we need to give a corticosteroid, such as dexamethasone, in addition to ceftriaxone. Why is that? When we treat with ceftriaxone, the death of Haemophilus influenza bacteria causes a release of lipopolysaccharide antigens, since Haemophilus influenza is a gram-negative bacteria. And that results in a strong immune response that destroys the neurons along with the bacteria. Consequently, that can cause neurological damage. Thus, giving corticosteroid is warranted because we want to decrease the immune response caused by the LPS release, which will then reduce the collateral damage to neurons. For the infections caused by the non-typable strains, we use amoxicillin with or without calvulinate. Lastly, to prevent infection with Haemophilus influenza type B, we have a vaccine that contains type B capsular polysaccharide polyribosyl ribitol phosphate, which is conjugated to diphtheria toxoid. The vaccine is given to children from 2 to 18 months old. As prophylaxis, we give rifampin to the close contacts of infected individuals to prevent infection. Does that remind you of a similar situation that we talked about before? Yes, in Nicirium and Indutatus, we do the exact same thing. So, that's all you need to know about Haemophilus influenza. Hope you enjoyed. Please give us your feedback so we can improve in the next videos. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to get our new videos and explanations. And as always, thanks for watching.